Hey guys, in this video I show you exactly how this guy ended up making a $50,000 boat for under $14,000. And this is just a reminder to like and subscribe to my channel to ensure other people can get the tips and hints that you are going to see on this video. This video is sponsored by Mini Jet Incorporated, so make sure to stick around to the end of this video to receive your very own discount code exclusive to APR Welding Academy. Alright, let's get right into it. So the kit I purchased was the Mini Jet DXF files. I'm just going to start off by saying I don't recommend anybody using these plans. They were very difficult to follow along with. There was a ton of mistakes that I had made just due to lack of instruction. The blueprints they provided weren't terrible. However, the bends sometimes didn't match up, even though I got a CNC press brake. And I got, you know, $300,000 worth of equipment that I use just to be able to get to the point where the parts were bent. So anybody who's doing a hobby, I highly suggest just going with a Mini Jet kit, do-it-yourself kit, if you have any welding experience. If you don't have any welding experience, don't worry, because Mini Jet Incorporated also sells welded hulls. Now, obviously, this is going to come with a little bit more of a pricey tag on it, just because of the simple fact that they have to ship a full hull rather than just a flat pallet. One more thing I'd like to mention is that the fact that you don't really save much money doing it all on your own, because of the simple fact that Mini Jet has it all figured out. They have plans, they have blueprints, they have guys that know exactly what to do, what to bend it to. They have machines all set up for just doing this specific thing. So another thing is they probably get their aluminum a lot cheaper. So at the end of the day, you're not saving much money by trying to do all the work yourself in a shop. Let's say you have a buddy that owns a shop. Well, now you're trying to bug him to use his shop, and you know, myself, even my own shop, it's hard for me to be able to get in there. So I can only go in there on nights and weekends because I have classes all day long. So, you know, it's not as easy as you think to go and try and make your own kit. Not to mention you're spending endless hours trying to make things match up that don't actually properly match up because they weren't made in a specialized kit. So I don't know about you guys, but I know my time is worth more, and I would rather just pay the extra $500 that it came out to, the real difference, and save myself almost probably 3 months worth of work. At this point, we're just making sure all of our corners match up, that our bends are actually proper, because I did have to re-bend a couple of these pieces. And just making sure that everything was still lining up the way it should. It was definitely a bonus to have a table at chest height so that everything you're working on was pretty ergonomically correct. It definitely saved a lot of sore backs and necks going home at night. So if you do have that option, I definitely suggest it. If you don't, try to fabricate something so that you can work off of a table. Right on, it's time to weld some aluminum. Be sure to smash that subscribe button to ensure you don't miss the next video of us installing the intake. And we have a secret surprise in our next video as well, so don't miss it. Alright guys, the moment you've all been waiting for. I have here an exclusive code to the Mini Jet Incorporated storefront on their website. So this code can only be used in the actual website itself. It can't be used on phone calls or email transactions. However, it can be used on any parts within their store. So unfortunately, it doesn't apply to the DIY kits or to the welded hulls. However, it does apply to every part that they sell in their store. So 5% is what you will get off. And if anybody has ever purchased anything from them, it's well worth it. Right on, well that was part one of my Mini Jet boat build. Ensure to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss part two of my Mini Jet boat build. In that video, I'll be explaining to you how I installed the intake, what measures to take, and pretty much specifics of how they expect you to install the intake, and what I would have done differently the next time I do install it.